We need to take a simple idle animation. Next, you need to remove all the curves from it. And also delete all frames except the first. Make 5 duplicates of this animation. Right, left, front, back, center. Now we do bulk editing via the property matrix. As a basic pose, take our very first animation from which we made duplicates. Check if animation has applied. This menu is a bit buggy. Now we need to change our animations in such a way, so that they are slightly lean to the base pose. Legs can be returned to a position with almost no tilt. Here you can experiment using different positions. You can also change the orientation of smaller bones. In the same way, you need to edit all 4 animations. Create a blend space 2D. The axis should be from -1 to 1. You can also change the parameter that is responsible for the smoothness of animation changes, target weight interpolation speed per sec. Now you need to place all 5 animations in blend space 2D. If you don't like the result, you can edit the animations. Now you need to apply the newly created blend space. It can be applied to any move machine. You also need to call a special function that does the calculation. The minimum speed at which lean will be applied. If the character moves less than this speed, lean will not be applied at all. The maximum speed here is needed only as a parameter for a lerp function. That is, lean will be used at full strength only if the character exceeds that speed. Zwill factor direction, coefficient when moving along the x-axis, i.e. left-right. Zwill factor acceleration and Zwill factor braking, coefficients when moving along the y-axis, i.e. when accelerating and decelerating. The following parameters are needed to remove back and forth movements when the maximum speed curve is applied. The stronger your curve, the more these values should be. Otherwise, the character will constantly lean forward or backward while applying the maximum speed curve. An additional function was introduced to remove the influence of the curve on lean. This function removes the effect of the maximum speed curve when the character turn. The parameter determines when to remove the effect of the curve. 0, this is a rectilinear movement, 1, a strong turn. Also now you can manually set the alpha for the max speed curve. Now we need to apply our calculations. This function has a parameter that determines how quickly the new values are applied. Lean is needed only when moving on the ground. If we are in a jump or swimming, it should be turned off. Now I will show how to apply additive animations. On the example of a landing after a jump, suppose we want an additional animation to be played when landing. As a basic pose, let's take just idle animation. Call a special function in the landing event. Set the play once parameter to true. And then the animation will play only one time and the additive node will auto turn off. Otherwise, you have to disable it yourself using disable additive animation. This function also has additional parameters. Previously, the landing animation also played, but using the additive in this case makes it possible. For example, to make an additional bend in the legs during the landing when moving. In the same way, you can play any additive animation, let's say a hand reaction when shooting, or a reaction to hit.